to 15 times a game. They've got to do it more judiciously. They can't afford the turnovers.
Worth spun around and submarined as an overwhelming deluge of Cougars, championed by Ed Oliver and Gerard Carter. For Navy, there's a new man in the middle, and he's the biggest starting center in program history.
6'2", and Morris is 325 pounds, and he's got a challenge. He's got Ed Oliver on the other side, who's one of the better nose tackles in the country, and he's only a freshman.
He gets the nod over Parker Wade, matching up with Oliver, who is a game changer. Chose Houston over Alabama, LSU, Texas, Notre Dame, UCLA, and Oklahoma. Worth on the keeper, and he is kept in the backfield, corralled by Cameron Malvo, the team captain for Houston. Let's meet the rest of the Cougars' starting defense. You mentioned Oliver. He is just different.
Yeah, Oliver's something. They're missing a couple of regular starters, but this is a defense that attacks. They start with the attacking in the middle with the nose tackle, Oliver. The linebackers attack. You see them against this option offense. They're going to cover with at least five guys, all the linemen for Navy. They're going to try to man them up and let their linebackers and safeties run at the ball.
Oliver got two of those three sacks in the opener against Oklahoma. Third and 13. Worth contained again. So Houston denies. And Navy, the fifth consecutive opponent, forced to punt on a game-opening possession against Houston.
And so far, so good. You're getting the penetration if you're Houston, and you're denying.
Here in supreme field position for Will Worth and the Navy offense.
Every lineman covered.
The pitch as they go to Chris High. And High surges in for a touchdown.
That was a great numbers game. You got the S back in motion. That brings the defender across the field. Nobody to take that pitch. Receiver ran off the cornerback. And that was just an easy 6 points, and as easy as you're going to see Navy having it running the ball. Navy had 112 yards last time they saw this defense, and they're the last defense or offense to run for over 100 yards.
Point after from Bennett Mooring is good. A long return by Dyson Romine. He streaks 82 to put Navy at the 12, and then it takes just one play. The pitch to Chris High. He High steps his fifth TD.
Last week. That they can't do with their defense. That leaves their defense on the field too much. That means points.
Worth the lead pitch to High. Runs through the first man, and Matthew Adams, and Howard Wilson at corner stumbles him after 13.
Not bad again, bringing that motion, getting a lot of the same kind of look, only the corner was there, and he gets faked out.
High had been averaging 8 yards a carry on the season entering this game.
He really, really blew out in that first game. He stood out huge for this offense.
A stumble by Worth. A loose football.
Did they get it?
As we check in with Brent Stover in New York City.
John, Notre Dame and NC State playing in a swamp. And B.J. Hill blocks a punt. Dexter Wright, scoop and score. Fourth quarter. The Wolfpack leading the Irish 10-3, guys.
Worth ruled down, second and 13 coming for Navy. Worth on second down. Push beyond the 45, Garrett Davis on the tackle.
Well, they're getting something right now they didn't get on a real regular basis last year against this defense. That's the edge. Good seal block right there by Cass. Playing the S-back on that one side, number 20. That's what these S-backs love to do for each other. They love the block. It's one of the rules Ivan Jasper, the offensive coordinator. You want the ball to run with? You got a block for your guys.
Third and five. Where might that block come? Later pitch. Tony O'Donnell, the captain, the first down. Undercut near the sideline by Garrett Davis. He bursts for 17.
Two things. Watch the support coming from over here, and then watch the wall that develops on this defense. Something that hasn't been happened real often to it. They've excelled at frustrating the run. Right now, they're covering guys inside, but the reaction time outside has really been lacking.
Last week, the worst rushing day for Navy since a UConn demolition back in 2002. Will Worth and company have found a second wind.
2002, the first year that Ken Niumatalolo came here to Navy as an assistant. He's had this offense just churning. Now, this year, they're averaging 250 yards a game rushing, which is significantly under what they normally do. Part of that's losing a great player like a Keenan Reynolds. Part of that's having the lack of experience they really had starting this season up front with this offensive line.
It is the lowest rushing average of 250 and change per game in the triple option era. 14th in the country. Navy has never finished lower than 6th since it employed this offense. Tony O'Gully again. Find the edge. Ed Oliver, the D tackle, drags him down to the 25. They get 10.
We're going to take you right down onto the field. You're going to see this option. Antonio Gully, you know what he does here? He just outmans, out abilities, out athletes the defensive side of the ball. He got some blocks. Jameer Tillman got a pretty good block on the quarterback.
Tell me one. Take the left one.
Gully, in a year that leaders have fallen, Tago Smith at quarterback. That's why Gully and Daniel Gonzalez changed their numbers to 2, the two captains of the team. They were captains back in their prep school days. As Calvin Cass slowly walks his way off the field.
That's one of the dangers, you'd have to say, normally comes when you're not the biggest guys in the world and you're out there blocking. I mean, Cass is 5'10", about 200 pounds. And he's out there blocking on linebackers and defensive ends. Give up a lot of size to some of these guys, and sometimes you become the hitty and not the hitter.
It is worth noting that Houston's without the services of Steven Taylor today, their top tackler. He's out for a violation of team policy. Tyus Bowser also still out with a broken orbital bone. A late pitch. Darryl Bonner hammered on the hip, and it thrusts him forward to the 14. 11 yards and another first down.
You can't emphasize enough that Navy is getting these corners, and they're getting it with blocks. What a beautiful job outside offensively by Adam West, pulling from that backside guard position and coming around and getting a good block on the cornerback. That's Adam West, 72, showing some pretty good athletic ability.
Chris High, the primary fullback, getting looked at by the athletic training staff. ...10-7, Houston has the lead. Chris High still wincing on the sidelines as we take a look at what happened to the Navy primary fullback.
Well, here's Chris High right here at fullback. Look at Carter right there, the right defensive end. Watch his right leg. Chris High goes right into the knee and thigh of the defensive lineman.
Wincing and limping noticeably.
That can be a shock from the top of your head down to the bottom of your heel.
So they've inserted Sean White at fullback. Worth tries to keep. He's chipped down around the 10 by Khalil Williams as we check in with Sheehan Stanford Birch.
Guys, just a couple updates on the Navy injuries. Calvin Cass we saw come off the field. They're going to update us on his progress. Right now they're assessing him for a head injury. And then you just saw Chris High come off the field. He was in a lot of pain. They say it's a bruise. He's working himself on the bike right now to loosen things up.
Well, thank you, Sheehan. Ken Niumatalolo has had the perfect storm of injury this year as Navy plays in a driving rain today. He's lost his quarterback. He's lost his top tackling linebacker. And now his primary fullback on the sidelines. Later pitch, the ball on the ground. Navy able to pounce. On a wet day, slick conditions, Darryl Bonner could not corral it cleanly.
Wow, again, watch. They've got the corner. Bonner doesn't look the ball in. Probably a touchdown if he catches the ball with that corner the way it was. Look it all the way in, then run with it. Heads up, looking for what's happening in front of him. Didn't follow the ball. Before that play, Navy had 76 yards rushing so far against this Houston defense, which is not used to being run on like this.
Houston hasn't allowed 100 yards rushing since these teams met in the game that decided entry into the American Championship game last year. Seven straight games not allowing 100 yards. The Navy midshipman, though, last week barely had more than 50 yards against Air Force in the first of the CIC games.
Well, the problem for them really was in that first half, they didn't stay on the field. When they were on the field, there were turnovers. There was a blocked kick. There was an interception by Will Wirth, who told us Thursday, yeah, if I had one do-over this year, it'd probably be that pass. I probably would have just ate the ball and taken the loss and not tried to throw it. We mentioned that from the get-go that they had to be flawless in this game. They haven't been flawless, but, man, they have executed on the edges so far against this top rank to one of the best defenses statistically in the country.
And third and seven. Worth. The ball squirts free as he got rocked by Zach Vaughn at 6'4", 270.
Tackle over right on that play. Had an overload working. Tried to roll that way with a pass. It wasn't there. Great ad-lib, though, by Worth, getting the yards he could out of it. Remember I talked about running to pass that Greg Ward Jr. was doing? That's running to run. That's Will Worth running against the way he throws the ball and trying to get as many yards as possible to make this a short field goal.
Bennett Mooring, 1-for-2 on field goals this year. 24 yards out. Proves that he's trying to work out of the bike. Big change for Navy compared to the Air Force contest last week. Sean White pushed out of bounds by DeJuan Hines.
You got to be honest, though. You've got a team like Houston coming in here, number six in the country, highly talented, highly touted. Should you really be surprised that a team like Navy, with it from an institution like this, wouldn't just fight and claw and come out given everything they possibly could have? Houston knew that coming in. They knew coming in they were going to get an all-day sucker, and Tom Herman has his team on a weekly basis. That's kind of how they approach everybody. But that's definitely what they're getting out of Navy.
Keeps on second and four. He's got the first down. Ed Oliver got him on the shoulder. Last year, Houston had a unique dynamic. The Cougars did not face Navy until game 12. They employed 10 different Sundays, 10 to 15 minutes apiece, working on the triple option. This year, Houston had four games in 19 days, two on Thursday nights, and they did not get nearly the same volume of reps against the triple option.
Chris High going to the locker room, trying to loosen that up inside.
On first and 10, the late pitch, Antonio Gully. He has had himself a day. The captain went out of bounds at around the 33. Rips off 19.
Yeah, they're doing a fantastic job on the edges, as I've talked about. Watch on the outside. You've got the receiver running him off. You get a block from the S-back, and then it's just Gully. You've got the rest of them. He has no problem with that. Actually, Houston got away with a little bit of a face mask there on the sideline.
Some booze pours down as the replay hit the video board. First and 10, Worth, he's picking up confidence and physical scheme, barrels his way to the 25 and to linebacker Matthew Adams for a gain of 8.
Especially last week against Air Force, but through these first four games or so, Ken Niumatalolo has not seen this out of Will Wirth. This is a more aggressive, more assertive offense in general, but especially Will Wirth, and already 124 yards offense. The most against this Houston defense since last year's Navy team down in Houston.
They had to go pass heavy in that game when Keenan Reynolds threw for over 300. Second down, Wirth has it, and more. Will Wirth to the 5-yard line. A 20-yard rumble. Howard Wilson, the cornerback, stopped the QB.
This is a great view. Look at all the white jerseys on the ground. This is from behind. You should see white jerseys in front of the blue jerseys. How about the wide receivers so far? Them and the slot backs on the outside have done a really nice job. That was more of a stock block attempt by Scott. But the exterior offense, especially the blocking part of it, has really been stellar so far for Navy. They have got this defense just on their heels. They're guessing. And when you guess against the option, maybe it is that extra Sunday practice time they're missing. But they're missing something right now.
Navy calls timeout. Navy on the doorstep at the 5.
Brent Stover in New York, a top 10 showdown over on CBS. Trevor Knight fires a dart to Christian Kirk. A&M early 7-0 lead on Tennessee, guys.
Big one in the SEC, Texas A&M and Tennessee. Tennessee, one of the two that entered today with a better active win streak than Houston.
This is the first half. They don't pay attention.
Will Wirth certainly paying attention. He's got 4 carries for a little under 45 yards. Khalil Williams, the stop. Houston's only allowed 2 red zone touchdowns all season in 5 such possessions.
Red zone touchdowns.
Yes.
Not of any variety, just touchdowns.
Yes.
Yeah, it's something the way this defense has played, especially coming in here, the way they stopped the run. Early on, first series, they looked like that defense. Since that big spark, that jolt of adrenaline on that kickoff return by Romine, it's really been something to see what this Navy football team's been able to do offensively.
Navy, though, exhausts its timeouts here. They seem to recognize the import of these early possessions, these early touches, as Will Wirth is at the heart of a huddle. Here are the numbers for Will Wirth. Contrast them with Keenan Reynolds' first 4 games of last season for the man who finished 5th in the Heisman voting against Will Wirth, who entered as the backup QB.
Well, they're throwing it a little bit more, obviously. He's had the 2 interceptions. The biggest difference to me coming in was right there at 173 yards rushing. Well, in this game, so far in this half, Will Wirth has been a huge weapon running the ball. You know, right now, he's got 61 yards rushing.
And Navy has time of possession. Houston entered 3rd in America in time of possession, 36 and a half minutes. Wirth keeps. And Will Wirth spins in for a score. Navy takes the lead, 16-13.
It was a great old movie. Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid being chased by a posse. They turn around and they say, who are those guys? Right now, this Houston defense, after watching the tape, especially of last week, they got to be looking at Will Wirth saying, who is this guy? Because this is not the guy they saw on tape.
Point after from Bennett Mooring is good. These are the most points allowed by Houston to a conference foe this season. And we're still early in the second quarter. Will Wirth gets high, and he gets in. His 6th rushing touchdown of the campaign. Navy leading.
9 yards passing, a touchdown, and 1 rush for 9 yards.
outstanding numbers to begin today. Navy's yet to throw a pass. Oliver stands up. Will Wirth. He loses about half a yard.
Yeah, Oliver can come from that nose tackle position. And in that particular case, they were trying a sort of a slip block where you get the center and the guard, the left guard in this case, on him. He broke right through the middle of that attempted double team for that tackle. That's the kind of player he is. And honestly, if you're going and you're coaching this kid, use his strength, which is his quickness. He's 290 pounds, but he's about as quick as a 240 player.
Works for play nearly even. A leader pitch to Bonner. He gets something to the edge. DeJuan Hines helped him out of bounds. Armed Forces football proudly supported by Golden Corral. After a six-yard jaunt, third down and four for a Navy team that entered top 20 in America, nearly 50% on third down.
Against a defense that's as good as anybody in the country preventing first downs. They get off the field as good as anybody on the country, but it's been an issue today.
Wirth, another later pitch by the lead is man, and the spinning hit spot seems to be about a yard shy.
Well, normally you'd say it's almost an automatic. You get closer to the 50 that Navy might go for this, but, you know, you never know with Ken Niumatalolo. He's already tried two onside kicks. Going for it on fourth down is not that out of the box, especially when it's only a yard.
Last year, Navy led America 92% on fourth down. This year, 4 of 8.
You're at home playing the number 6 team in the country. I like this. Show your guys your faith in.
Wirth keeps. Big hit, but Wirth has it to the 40-yard line.
Oh, and I forgot the new Will Wirth. You know, the old Will Wirth in the first couple of games, maybe you punt here. The new Will Wirth, you know, if he gets hit at the line of scrimmage, he's powering through that sucker, and it's exactly what he did. Got hit at the line of scrimmage and got the first down for Coach Niumatalolo.
And that's what this Navy coaching staff said of Will Wirth in the infancy of his quarterbacking this year. He brought a grit, a toughness, and that's on supreme display so far. Miles Swain at fullback. Later pitch to Gully. Gully contained by Matthew Adams.
Gully Adams was engulfed.
The Navy knows Adams well. He had a team high and career high 11 tackles when the teams met last year, but didn't play last week against UConn. He had a scuffle with fellow linebacker Tyus Bowser when they were playing some team-building games, games like tag and water guns, and it got a little too intense in their family Friday, which was moved to Wednesday.
I'm sorry, excuse me. In a team-building drill, somebody got mad and punched the other guy.
And broke an orbital bone. Wirth, first look in the air today for Navy. Incomplete, nearly picked off. Garrett Davis hung in the air and bobbled the ball as he crashed down.
Ball just not thrown quite far enough. Ball comes up short. You saw it had that sort of nose up, high speed wobble working. You throw a pass like this, especially you've got the corner on the receiver and the safety over the top for help. You better throw that thing on the far outside of your receiver. Otherwise, it's going to be either an interception or a near interception like that.
And it puts Navy in a harder spot in third and 11 after the first Navy pass attempt of the game. Pitch streaks nearly to midfield. Matthew Adams, another tackle. The spot goes to the 45. They've gone for it on fourth down on this possession, but this is fourth down and 5 right now.
Yeah, this is a little bit different. Fourth down and about 2 feet earlier. This is 5 yards. Good call by Coach Niumatalolo, keeping his team on the field for another possession. Now it's up to the defense for Navy with here about 5 minutes to go to try to see if they can put a little hitch in the get-along Greg Ward in this offense, because last drive they were pretty doggone good.
Not Eric Harris. Alex Barta punts. Fair catch. That's the first career pick for Josiah Powell and the third thrown by Greg Ward Jr. this year.
He baited a pretty good quarterback into a bad throw. Good defense.
Navy's total of defensive interceptions on the season entering this game, one. Navy with 2:50 to go before halftime. Remember, no timeouts. Navy exhausted its timeouts on the early side of the game. Houston employs one here.
Well, Navy's still been all run. One pass attempt, 0 for 1. But every one of the 166 yards has come on the ground.
Coming up on the Halftime Report, powered by Ram Trucks, Brent Stover, Houston Nutt, Christian Fourier, and Jimmy Clausen stand by in our New York studio. We'll get you up to speed on all the action on a very busy college football Saturday. Head your way on the Ram Trucks Halftime Report.
Yeah, they'll have plenty of stuff to talk about, starting with that Oklahoma-Texas game. Oklahoma putting Charlie Strong pretty much to sleep with another loss, especially scoring 45 points doing it. Another time with this interception. Nice job hooking up. But Powell, as that ball gets tipped, it buys him that extra time to react inside.
Micah Thomas had the tip. So Tom Herman's team sends the defense back out. Nothing. Three white jerseys surround him. Cameron Malvo, who had a career-high 6 tackles the last time these teams met, smothers him. Today's first down line brought to you by Golden Corral.
Yeah, another one of the attempts at one of those great late pitches. You don't always get rid of it.
Navy's got to get to around the 33 for a field goal, but Worth loses his footing and collapses at the 30.
Well, that looked like his offensive line. Maybe Ed Oliver inside had a little effect, pushing his center Morris into the quarterback. I think between Morris and Wood, they stomped down and got a little bit. I mean, Evan Martin was the right guard, so it was Morris and Martin stepping on their quarterback. Good nose tackle will make you do that, especially when he's trying to penetrate.
In his first career start. Worth down again. Ed Oliver has been so disruptive, that time at concert with Zach Vaughn. Another timeout called by Houston.
That was a group chomp down. They're starting to move around a little bit more up front, John, these last couple possessions. Houston's defense is starting to give them a little bit of motion. Oliver coming from the backside. He went all the way around Morris. The guard didn't get him down, and he still gets into him. Pretty amazing.
Let's take a look at the ride that Will Worth has been on today.
And what's made him amazing is two things. He's been so aggressive running the ball, John. And, man, his decision making with this ball flipping out on these pitches has been just perfect.
Punt barely off. Punter run into. Flag is out. De'Ara King on a run back. King into Navy territory, but the flag is down back where Alex Barta, who was out to punt again instead of Eric Harris, was run into after he got the kick away.
And just from the first blush, it looked like it was an actual run into the kicker, not a thespian effort by the young man at the punter position.
And Barta began the year as the starting punter. Lost it during the course of a game to Harris. As Barta has a long leg, but had it positioned as well. Referee Adam Sablois, 2 penalties on the play, but the personal foul for roughing the kicker goes on Isaiah Johnson, wide receiver.
And Johnson was kind of spinning off that attempted block by the up back. Mistimed his spin because it spun him right into Barta.
These are two of the least penalized teams in the game. Navy, the fewest penalties in America, 2.5 a game. Houston, 4 at 3 a game. New life for Navy's offense, but Will Wirth refusing to yield. Gets angled out of bounds by Ed Oliver.
That was almost Will Wirth magic. Because from the force up by the safety, it looked like he was going to cut Will Wirth in half. And suddenly Will Wirth came squirting out the other side, still with the ball and still going forward.
Second down and 2. Without clean footing, a late pitch, and what a violent collision. Huge hit as Matthew Adams at linebacker just obliterates.
And if for the first time today, there's proper pitch perspective from a defensive standpoint. You make the quarterback pitch it, and you've got somebody right there to put a nice form tackle bone on the back just as he catches it.
Third and 5. A rare trip to the air. And Worth has the first down. Darryl Bonner against Khalil Williams.
Yeah, Ivan Jasper, the offensive coordinator for Navy, when Tago Smith went down, he said, you know, I've got faith in Will Worth. I know he can throw the ball. And those kind of passes are a real improvement in this offense.
25 yards, so Randy, 44 seconds, no timeouts. You're already in longer field goal range.
Got to be aware of where you are and get out of bounds.
Later pitch, Gully. A warrior today.
Now it's a 37-yard field goal, so get to the ball, line up, and if you're Houston, be disruptive. Do not let the ball on the perimeter. Do not let the ball get out of bounds. Late substitution for Navy.
Worth stood up as he hurdled one defender, and Oliver was right there. 10 seconds.
There's a nose guard play for you by Ed Oliver.
Worth able to spike. So 4 seconds frozen on the clock as Bennett Mooring, who's converted from 24, jogs on. In advance of the season, Kenny Amontalolo told us he was comfortable with Mooring 50 yards and in. He said he was very accurate, but didn't have a much longer leg than about 50.
And Will Wirth in the offense, the reason they get a chance to do this field goal, great coordination getting on the ball and saving these last 4 seconds after getting blown up on that run, by the way.
And a timeout, Houston, before the snap, final timeout between the two teams.
Well, this is all set up on that fourth down with the running into the kicker on Bada. You know, Dunon Bada, the punter, that kept this drive alive. And keeping the drive alive set up Will Wirth for a chance to throw that 25-yard pass out there, pick up those yards, and then pick up some more yards by himself. Tell you, when I first saw Ed Oliver clear that line and just put Will Wirth down, I thought this clock might run out. I know I've said it once, but that was an excellent job by the offense getting up there, killing the ball, and saving time for the kick.
Saw that work in Navy's favor against UConn, the last Navy home game. From 39, Mooring through a career long. Ties the...
More of the same out of this Navy offense in the first play, and that means receiver on the outside running off the corner. Will Wirth holding the ball till the last second and then pitching it out and having an easy corner for his trailing back to be able to run on.
We saw the number for Navy. Just one loss with +2 in the turnover margin. Number Kendi Amontalolo. Bonner sidesteps. Dewan Hines grasps him around the ankle. As we take a look at field eye, there's a Cougar down.
You look right at it coming down the sideline. Same view as the official. How about that for a jump cut by Bonner? I'd have blown out an ankle, not to mention the side of my shoe, if I tried to stop that fast.
and doing it in wet conditions. Howard Wilson, the starting quarterback, getting looked at. He's the man who leads Houston with three interceptions. He's their best cover man. Gully giving the block in the back of his head, smashed down.
Remember, they're already down again this week. Brandon Wilson, the other corner, who's such a great talent when he gets his hands on the ball, both with an interception and a returner. But up front, they don't have Stephen Taylor again. He's out for this game. Coach's decision, team rules.
Second and seven, Sean White. Just beyond the 25.
White to the carry on the right side.
Leo Williams the tackle. Houston has given it away twice. Can Navy turn that into points? A Navy team that early gambled some, went for a consecutive onside kicks, but forged a deadlock at the break.
You get here third and four. The one guy you better block is Ed Oliver in the middle of this defense. They're covering up both guards in the center inside. Basically all five down linemen. You see, everybody's got a guy in front of him, whether he's in a two-point or a three-point.
Later pitch. Roman has speed on the edge. Khalil Williams sticks him on the hip. He breaks the plane to the 20. That is good for a Navy first down.
You know, you mentioned earlier in the first half, John, that Houston last year, when they played this Navy option at the very end of the season, spent time in spring, spent time in the offseason, spent time on Sundays after games working on the option. And they were ready for Navy last year in that 13th game. I don't know. They don't look like the same defense. I watched that tape. They were aggressive. They attacked. They're not attacking this option.
Inside run gets a few. They are down some big personnel today, and Oliver gets this last stick. But no Tyus Bowser, and you touched on it. Stephen Taylor, the team's top tackler, had a career-high 9 in the UConn game last week on Thursday. He's the sack master, the greatest tackle-for-loss machine that they employ. His loss really felt containing this Navy triple option.
Well, it enables them to sort of be a pincer defense because they got the inside with Oliver and the outside with Taylor, and they're missing half a pincer.
They fake to the air. Touchdown, Navy! Darryl Bonner gets the score, and Navy takes a 26-20 lead.
That was some wonderful subterfuge. You run a quick little fake, you have motion, and you trap the linebacker inside.
College football, but in life this year, suffered by the Army Black Knights. Kendi Amatalolo, who's an emotional coach. You see it every year in the Army-Navy game. The tears well up. Of course, last year had a special little extra edge with the possibilities of BYU.
It was a special relationship with these coaches and their players at the military academies.
Give up inside to Sean White. Gerard Carter on the D-line with the stop.
It was a great opportunity for Sean White, the big fullback, 6'1", 255. Chris High, we talked about earlier, won't be back from that bruise he suffered earlier. And Chris White, he's got all the qualifications, size, speed, everything else. But Sean White, he can really run.
They liked Sean White the most going into camp. Another run up the gut that baffled some on the Houston defense. Gerard Carter, another stick. But Sean White got hurt the first practice in pads in fall camp. Missed 2 weeks and was so far behind that High won the job and Swain was getting the second reps.
And when you're a fullback, you need all the reps you can get with that timing. And for Navy's offense, third and two, you better block number 10. Right in the middle, right there, the nose tackle. That's the guy you better worry about.
Worth pitches. He has been so brilliant with that today. The edge, the first. first down and more as DeLon Hines wraps up Dyson Romine, but Romine rips off 19.
Look at the personnel. They're covering every lineman. That means there's five guys inside, but the corner out here is wide open after that pitch. Will Worth, he's willing to save it to the last second, take that shot, and get that ball to Romine.
And Worth, his grit, his toughness, his decision-making on brilliant display today, but also the play calling upstairs. Ivan Jasper, an inside run to Sean White. Ivan Jasper told us last week, or told us in advance of this week, that the Air Force game a week ago was somewhat on him, that he did not put his team, his players, in a position to be successful offensively. And you know that the loss against Houston last year still stings. The only conference loss that Navy has suffered since joining the American.
I'll tell you, if you're going to take that responsibility for last year and last week, you got to take the credit for this one. Because right now, this has been a masterful job by the Navy offensive coaches.
Second and one. Worth somehow kept his footing, and they get the first down. Darryl Bonner. They continue to roll in fresh faces at that slot back position, and they keep getting results.
That is really something that's happening to this Houston defense, and they're starting to look very frustrated because they're not used to people gashing them with the run. And as fast as they are, they're not used to seeing people outflank them.
Navy has had 10 plays of double-digit yards in this game. Overwhelmingly on the ground against a team that entered first in America, 42 yards rushing allowed per game.
230 so far.
Trumping the first five combined. Will Worth running through multiple Cougars, including Matthew Adams. B.J. Singleton at 314 pounds finally stumbles him in the 34.
This play here, this is all about Will Worth. It's blocked okay. There's one. There's two, there's three, there's four. The fifth Houston Cougar that puts his hands on Will Worth finally puts him down. That's all about inside running, and that's just not wanting to go down. And this is a different Will Worth. He's still a leader, he's always been. But, man, he's showing some toughness today.
Second down and less than two. Gully motions. Worth taking a shot. Launches.
The number six team in the country's got all they want. Brandon Colon lined up where normally the S-back would be lined up. Normally the slot back is in that position. He's not. He's a receiver. He ran up the field and caught that like a receiver.
Point since November of 2010 against Arkansas State. It was done by Chase Burge. Today's first down line brought to you by Navy Federal Credit Union.
John, we've seen this Navy offense when it comes to a clock on a team. I mean, they have run the ball like crazy today. I mean, 42 yards a game is what they were averaging giving up was Houston. Right now, they have 238 yards, but that time on the clock, the running game has got to be a constrictor. You got to start choking off the time. Stay on the field if you're Navy. Get them off if you're Houston.
Worth. He has run through first and sometimes second and third hitters so often. Matthew Adams this time just shrugged off by the QB.
Yeah, he's had almost an out-of-body experience because, I mean, he's putting his shoulders into people. He's getting some decent blocking. But he's showing spin moves, and he's showing a resilience we haven't seen out of him. And I know Houston was not ready for this performance by Will Worth. He's been that big of a difference.
Remember, he has a new center today, Maurice Morris, 6'2", 327, started, not Parker Wade. Worth decides to keep. His decision-making has been spot on as he hurdles multiple defenders. About a yard shy of the first down, Ed Oliver, the stop.
And we've talked about that offensive line for Coach Niumatalolo. Every guy's got somebody to block. And as good as Ed Oliver is at nose guard, Morris, making his first start, has done a really nice job for most of the game blocking on him. You know, as has Adam West at the other guard, Martin at right guard. Inside out is how you beat people, and right now, Navy is beating Houston inside out.
Looking for its third ever win, as you saw on the graphic, against a top 10 team here at Navy Marine Corps.
30 seconds.
Timeout called by Navy. Ken Diamantololo, the winningest head coach in Navy history, but you have to go back a long way to the last win of that ilk, 1984 against South Carolina. Eric Rutherford had 11 tackles, 4 sacks, and a field goal block. Rich Klaus, a 53-yard run. Navy scored 31 unanswered points and upset number 2 South Carolina, 38-21. It's Navy's last win over a top 10 team. And who saw that one coming? Navy entered that game 3-5-1. This Navy team entered 3-1 unblemished in the American.
And, you know, 2.5 touchdown underdog in this game coming in. So it's not like many people gave them a chance coming in here.
Crucial 3rd-and-1. Worth keeps, and his plunge moves the Chiefs.
Well, he puts that foot in the ground at the end of that run and dives forward. That's why he gets a first down. Not a bad job by the defense of Houston. They're there. But Will Worth won't be denied. He gets forward, gets his first down, keeps his offense on the field, keeps that clock moving, more importantly for them.
Navy has won 20 of 24. The losses in that time, 2 to Notre Dame, 1 to Houston. All 3 of those nationally ranked, and the CIC game to a big rival in the Air Force last week.
White with the carry.
Davis takes care of Sean White at the 41.
Look at this defense. You got man, 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 man. Okay, what do? You're running a gap. Adam West gets a great block. He sets, turns his guy out slightly, and White's able to run up right behind him.
West called by the coaching staff, the prototypical Navy guard with the size and quickness. And Worth steamrolling Cougars. The first down jaunt to the 39, 20 yards for Worth. Howard Wilson, the tackle.
Yeah, the Navy offense has turned this into a bruise waiting to happen. In that case, they pulled Evan Martin, the right guard. Will Worth runs against the grain, sees a hole, and just puts his foot in the ground and cuts back against the defense.
That's multiple times. He has won the battle with Matthew Adams, starting linebacker, and he's been more physical. Worth over 100 yards on the ground today. Here's a few for Sean White. DeJuan Hines, the hit.
Yeah, what a contrast to last week against Air Force, where he came away with -6 because of all the sacks. Today, 102 so far. But as a team, and we talked about it early, but it's worth mentioning, this is an offense that was held to 47 yards. I mean, you couldn't ask for a bigger contrast week to week.
The inside give, Houston right there on the spot. Armed Forces football, proudly supported by Northrop Grumman. Sean White has had to shoulder a lot of the load. You do see Miles Swain check in at fullback, who had just 1 carry on the season entering this game. But Chris High, who rumbled 12 yards for a score early, is out for the rest of the game with a bruise.
You got to be careful with this Navy offense if you're Houston. Keep playing the run inside well, but you better account for those S-backs.
And it's a toss to Gully. Gully turns the corner. Gully stumbles out of bounds. Another first down.
How about the blocks outside? Tillman gets one. Bonner gets a great block on the outside. He flips himself a cornerback right there. Man, defensive backs hate cut blocks. You get down their legs and start getting them up in the air. I'm not saying they tap out, but DBs start finding ways around you when you get down on their legs.
11 yards. Bonner, the big block. He has a touchdown himself today. Worth keeps. He is dropping the shoulder and welcoming this contact.
Okay, he's going to need about an ice bag the size of his body after this game. No wonder he could submerge himself in ice water. Because this offense right now, led by Will Wirth, is doing exactly what we talked about. They're staying on the field, they're running the ball, and they're having their way with this defense. And I'm going to say it again, Houston averaged, they were giving them 42 yards a game rushing coming into this game. Right now, Navy 292.
Inside run. Healthy diet of fullback plunges. Matthew Adams the stop. The defensive architect for Houston, Todd Orlando, who at Utah State for a couple of years, had a top 12 FBS scoring defense, top 5 tackles for loss. This year, the rush defense was first in the FBS for yards per game, for yards per carry. And the scoring defense, Randy, was third in America, 11.2 per game. Navy's got 41 on the board.
Steven Taylor not being there as a linebacker, the guy that leads them in tackles for losses and sacks and an attacking player. Yeah, it's mattered. I'm not sure how much it's mattered the way Navy's blocked them.
Third and 4, Worth to the right. Worth decides to keep late, and he takes the chip from Oliver. He's down at the 15-yard line. Move the chains again.
Ed Oliver, that freshman nose tackle, 6'2", 290 pounds, moves really well. That's a lot of nose guard to be hitting you. I don't care how old he is. Will Worth just deflected right around him and just spun off the tackle.
They're going to take another look at this play to see where he is down if he does have the first down.
Oliver hits him right there. Okay, the ball, the knee went down, so it's short of that line. There's the hit, there's the knee, ball's down. Should be right at, maybe at the front end of the 15-yard line.
It was 3rd and 4 from the 19. The ball was spotted clean at the 15. The call on the field is first down.
Right there, the knee is down.
And remember, if he's short, you're looking at 4th down, and that's decision-making time for Kendi Amontalolo, employing a kicker that has made 2 today but had made 1 on his career entering this game.
Well, the points enter the equation too. You're under 7 minutes of time. You're currently leading by 8. If you get to 4th down, you risk not getting ahead by 11. You're forcing them to score 2 touchdowns if you kick this field goal.
And you're also looking at, in a 4th and short situation, you've already eaten up 6.5 minutes. If you were to go for it on a 4th down, you could exhaust even more time off a clock that stood at 13 minutes, 18 seconds at the start of the drive.
This is their drive of the game. I have no qualms about that. One more look at when the knee goes down and where the ball is. I think it's right at that line, right at the 15-yard line, maybe the very beginning of the 15-yard line. Either way, I think it's a 1st down.
And the call on the field was 1st down. Roy Reynolds, our replay official, has been called upon multiple times today.
But we're talking about that 4th down. I'm not saying I would be surprised if Ken Niumatalolo went for it on 4th down. I never am, as much confidence as he has in his running game.
But the chance to make it a 2-score game.
I'm just saying that's what you're passing up if you do go in. I mean, the stakes. In poker, they call it going all in. If this isn't a 1st down and it's 4th and... microscopic, you're either putting every chip on the pile or you're kicking the field goal and going up by 11.
scoring. Their field goal kicker entered 1 of 2 on the year with a block from 32 yards out. That would be the approximate distance if this changes. Let's see what the call is.
After review, the runner was down short of the line to gain. It will be Navy ball, fourth down, 1 half to go at the 15.5-yard line.
So fourth down and half a yard at the 15.5. What do you do?
Oh, here's that decision we talked about. Do you kick the field goal and go up by 11? Do you tell your quarterback, Will Worth, get up there and bark and scream and yell and try to get somebody to jump off, and then we'll kick the field goal?
This is a Navy team that kicked 2 onside kicks in the game's infancy.
They've been all in from the jump. So this should surprise absolutely nobody, especially Tom Herman and the Cougars. All the pressure right here is on that freshman right there, the nose tackle, Ed Oliver. You've got to handle a 325-pound center in Morris, and you got to worry about a sneak.
Motion from Romine. Inside run wide, and he does not have it. Matthew Adams. So here's Will Worth and company. This has been Worth's coming out party at quarterback. Worth keeps head over heels. Juan Hines the stop. He gets a couple. Today's first down line brought to you by Navy Federal Credit Union. As Navy seeks its biggest upset victory in 32 years. The last time a foe this high was felled by the midshipmen, 1984. Against South Carolina, a Navy team that entered that game 3-5-2.
And Houston's got all 3 timeouts left. Tom Herman has to hope they don't have to use many of them. And then get it just a plain, generic stop.
Another keeper for Worth. Volume hits, the latest from Matthew Adams. So the first timeout called here by Houston with 4:49 remaining. One of the great strengths of this Navy team in the triple option era. You got a 2-score lead, under 5 to go in the fourth. Ken Niumatalolo and company rarely lose.
Yeah, they rarely lose, and it's a very festive atmosphere here. I mean, the crowd is going crazy, but they haven't got this 2-touchdown lead by utter dominance. Houston has cooperated. Now there's a missed extra point, a block extra point, rather. That figured into it. A high snap that turns into a safety. Don't forget the interceptions. Don't forget the fumble. So Houston is more than implicit in the current situation they're sitting in.
And points off turnovers, 17-0 in favor of Navy. The pick 6, another pick, and a fumble, all on quarterback Greg Ward Jr. Yeah, granted, one of the picks was tipped.
They made that fourth down decision by Ken Niumatalolo, a moot point. You know, not kicking that field goal and going up by 11.
Swing in at fullback, Worth keeps again. He's had a career day, making 115 yards rushing now. DeJuan Hines, Matt Adams deny Worth. Another timeout called by Houston. Worth entered with 173 yards rushing on the year.
And that leaves probably, I'd say, Will Worth with that many yards, maybe a lump on his body for every loss.
For Houston, it's been only one loss of the Tom Herman era. The last time, the only time, November 21, 2015 in East Hartford. Fourth quarter, wide receiver pass, a 45-yard score extended UConn's lead. Greg Ward Jr. sidelined, an ankle injury most of the game. Subbed in on the final play and threw the game-sealing pick. Playoff hopes crushed for the Cougars, 20-17. They had not known a 2-score deficit from that day last November until today.
Navy's got a lot of people on the field right now.
Massive change.
Houston gets a chance to change out too when you're doing that many substitutions.
Fourth down and 3.
Yeah, this is just
just an attempt to try to get them to jump offside and do something dumb.
So no snap. And a timeout called by Navy. Tomorrow, the NFL on CBS throws down a big-time doubleheader. First, the Jets take off with the Steelers, while Tom Brady returns as the Patriots face the Browns. Then the Bengals battle the Cowboys in Big D. Check local listings, beginning with the NFL Today, presented by Southwest Airlines.
How about them Cowboys with Dak Prescott at the helm? It's going to make that an awful tough decision if they keep winning when Tony Romo comes back.
Still yet to throw a pick, but Jerry Jones has said that when Romo's back, the job is his. We'll see the reality. Bennett Mooring has converted from 38 and 24 today, from 40. Lead snap and spot, the kick on the way. Bennett Mooring had one field goal made entering this game. He connects on his.
Got to the 10-yard minimum and had to go. Might have had a chance.
So the ball at the 49. Houston has one timeout.
Not real complicated. Clock is oxygen, and it's all on Navy's side.
Some issue on the exchange. Both teams pile. Navy maintains. Navy falls on the free football. Houston calls timeout.
One more time. Will Wirth has to dive in there and recover that. Didn't ride with the center.
Let's go to New York City for an update on the Northern Illinois-Western Michigan game.
Guys, fireworks early on. Western Michigan on their opening drive just scored a touchdown. Northern Illinois and Western Michigan underway and available at cbssports.com/live. 2 minutes in, 6-0 Broncos. They are unbeaten. We'll get you there when you're done at Navy.
Well, thank you, Brent. Northern Illinois has won 7 straight in that series, but Western Michigan undefeated, 0 turnovers this year. And Randy, number 25 in the coaches' poll, top receiving votes AP, right in front of your UCLA Bruins.
They're rowing that boat right now. They really are. That's a team all heading in one direction, that's for sure.
Navy attempting the same. They toss Miles Swain. Houston has exhausted its timeouts. DeJuan Hines, the tackle. Navy up 6 on the nation's number 6 team. The Houston Cougar Club that has lost once in the 2-year tenure of Tom Herman.
Now you're looking, if you're Houston, your defense has got to stop them. And then you're going to have to reproduce a little bit of what Joshua Dobbs in Tennessee did last week to Georgia. Though it doesn't figure to be you're going to be far enough down the field to make that all happen in one throw.
Play clock at 2. Worth. It's no yards. So it'll be about a 17-second differential. Jeremy Winchester, the tackle.
You're in no hurry here. You'll take the 5-yard penalty. Let this clock run, the play clock run all the way out, every 22 seconds of it. Leave 15 on the clock by the time this ball is, next time you hear the whistle blow.